Amen.
Donc le Bible nous dit amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Good morning, everybody.
Mbote la bino ni onso.
Comment ça va?
Ça va bien.
Amen. Amen. Well, I want to say thank you to Pastor Eric and Mama Vivian.
Nalingi kotonda Pastor Eric pe Mama Vivian.
For making me, for adopting me as a member of this family.
Pona ko adoptenga lokola moko ya ba membre na libota oyo.
I want to thank you for your generosity and your hospitality.
Na tondio pona hospitalité na bino pe generosité.
And more than anything else, your friendship.
Pe koleka nyonso kiboninga.
I've been made to feel so welcome in this house. I don't want to go back to London.
Awa nazo kamalambo ya minga kitoko koleka nazo kwa kutko zonga tena long.
Thank you very much,
Matondi
man of God and woman of God. May God continue to prosper the work of God in your hands.
Mosala nzambe ya mwa sipe mobali nzambe akoba kofulisa lotomo na bino.
Amen. I also want to say thank you to Parole de vérité.
Naliko la paix, merci na parole de vérité.
Thank you for welcoming me.
Merci neno kwa yambaki ngai.
I want to thank the cell leaders and the people that we've ministered to over this past week.
Na pesi merci na ba responsable ya cellule pe ba tunyonso ba yamba kingai.
Thank you for your grace, for the grace of God upon you.
Matondi pona ngolu na nzambe liko na bino.
And I thank God for your patience with me all throughout the teachings.
E puis na tondi nzambe pona patience na bino bozalaki lango na malakisi oto zalaki na semaine.
And as Pastor said to most of you over this week,
Pastor Ayesegi na bino nyoso na semaine on,
it is time to go and do the work.
Sikoyo ekutango ekokipo na kokene kosala mosala.
And so my message this morning is about what we need to do this great work.
Matena ngai na tonga lelo zali oyo esengeli na biso pona tweba na kosala mosala oyo ya makasi.
There are three things that are needed to become a nation.
Ezali na biloko misato oto sengeli poto koma nation.
When you want to start a nation, you need three things.
Soki olingo banda nation esengeli ozala na biloko misato.
You need a piece of land.
Esengeli ozala na kimia mabele.
You need a lot of people.
Esengeli batubele bazala.
And you need a constitution.
Esengeli pe constitution ezala.
Amen.
Amen.
So when God was going to make Abraham father of many nations,
tango nzambe kokomisa Abraham papa ya mabote ebele,
he sent his descendants to Egypt.
Atindaki in Egypt.
And while they were in Egypt,
tango bazalaki na Egypt,
the Bible says that they multiplied exceedingly.
Bibelo bi makomaki ebele base multipliaki.
They multiplied so much that the Egyptians were afraid of them.
Base multipliaki makasi ba Egyptians bakome kobanga bango.
When we multiply as the children of God, our enemies are afraid of us.
Tango tozali ko se multiplier lokola bana nzambe ba yina biso bazobanga biso mbala mako.
The Bible says,
Bibelo bi,
if you have children,
so bozana bana.
No, the Bible says,
Bibelo bi,
children are like arrows in the quiver of a strong man.
Bana batilo flesh na ebomba melo ya flesh na mokongo na moto.
And when you have many of them, you will contend with your enemies at the gate.
Okoyeba na ko konteni ba enemi na yo.
What this means
is
a picture of what used to happen in ancient Israel.
Ezali endilinge sele ko salama na libota Israel.
The elders of a city will sit at the gate of the city to pass judgment.
Ba paka ya lingomba ba kofanda liboso na mboka pona kosala jugement.
And so if I have a problem with this brother,
soki nazala problem nande ko mobali oyo,
I will take him to court at the gate of the city.
Na komema ye na tribunal epi na ekuke ya ngumba.
And I will state my case, he will state his case.
Ye akoloba kana ye ngaka nakoloba kana nga.
But the Bible says,
Bibi elobi,
if he has a lot of children behind him,
soki azali na bana ebele,
if he has a bigger crowd behind him, he will speak against his enemies at the gate. If I'm only three people, if there are only three people with me, and he has 500 people with him, every time I want to say something, they will all shout me down.
Tango
and so by the power of the numbers of people behind him, he would defeat me at the gate.
Nanguya ya batebele oyazana bango ye akweba na kolonga ngai na ekuke ya ngomba.
So the Bible says that when you have children in your quiver than a fool, you will contend with your enemies at the gate.
Biblia zolo basoko zali na bana ebele okuyeba na kolonga bayina yo na ekuke.
The vision of discipleship.
Vision ya disciple.
The vision of sales.
Vision ya cellule.
That God has given this house.
Oh, Zamba pese tomoyo.
It's about the fact that it is time now for the children of God.
Ezali tangwe kokipo na bana nzambe.
To contend with the enemy at the gate.
Koyeba na kolonga moyini liboso na kuke.
It is time for the children of God.
Ekokitango pona bana nzambe.
In this house.
Na eglise oyo.
To rise up.
Kotelema.
And take their possession.
Pe koyeba na ko changer ba position na bango.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so in Egypt.
Egypt,
the children of Israel multiplied. And the Egyptians were afraid of them. So they decided to put them, to turn them into slaves. But God allowed them to multiply even in their slavery. And so that when the time came, if when the time comes, for them to go and possess their promised land, they have the numbers to contend with their enemies. They have the numbers to become a
nation.
And so they multiplied in Egypt. They fulfilled the first
condition.
So for you to be a
nation,
you must have people. A nation is the gathering of the indigenous of that place. It's the gathering of the people of that place.
Nation ezali kosangisa ya bato na sika wana.
The second thing is a constitution.
Eloko mibale ezali constitution.
And so when they got into the wilderness,
tango bakendaki na desert,
God gave them the laws of Moses.
Nzamba pesaki bango mibeko ya Moïse.
So now they have a constitution.
Siko bazalaki na constitution.
And then with their constitution and their people, they were able to possess the land.
Na constitution na bato.
We have a land. This ground God has given you. You have the word of God as your constitution. Now it is time to multiply.
It is time to multiply.
So that you can fulfill the destiny of God for this church. What is the destiny of God for this church? It is to expand the kingdom of God. What is the kingdom of God? The kingdom of God is the rule and the reign of God. God wants to rule and reign in the nation of Congo through your life. God wants to expand his kingdom through your life. That is the reason why he saved you. That's the reason why Jesus Christ came and died on the cross. Jesus Christ is the king of that kingdom. And he's the one that wants to rule and reign in your life and rule and reign through your life. And so we think, with all the challenges of life, how is this going to happen? It will happen. By the grace of God. It will happen. By the grace of God. And so what do we need to do this work? We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God. We need the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. In Ephesians chapter 2,
Ephesians chapter 2,
from verse 11,
na verse nango 11,
to verse 18.
Na verset 11, ti verset nango 18.
No, no, let's take it from verse 1.
Tu bandi na verset 1
to verse 10.
Verset 1 jusqu'à verset 10.
Yes, please.
Ephésiens chapitre 2, verset 1 à 10. Nous lisons au nom de Jésus-Christ. Vous étiez morts par vos offenses et par vos péchés, dans lesquels vous marchiez autrefois, selon le train de ce monde, selon le prince de la puissance de l'heure, de l'esprit qui agit maintenant dans le fils de la rébellion. Nous tous aussi, nous étions de leur nombre, et nous vivons autrefois selon les convoitises de notre chair, accomplissant les volontés de la chair et de nos pensées, et nous étions par nature des enfants de colère comme les autres. Mais Dieu, qui est riche en miséricorde, à cause du grand amour dont il nous a aimés, nous qui étions morts par nos offenses, nous a rendus à la vie avec Christ. C'est par la grâce que vous êtes sauvés. Il nous a ressuscités ensemble et nous a fait asseoir ensemble dans les lieux célestes en Jésus-Christ. Enfin, de montrer dans les siècles à venir l'infinie richesse de sa grâce par sa bonté envers nous en Jésus-Christ. Car c'est par la grâce que vous êtes sauvés, par les moyens de la foi. Et cela ne vient pas de vous, c'est le don de Dieu. Ce n'est point par les œuvres, afin que personne ne se glorifie. Car nous sommes son ouvrage, ayant été créés en Jésus-Christ pour des bonnes œuvres, que Dieu a préparées d'avance, afin que nous les pratiquions.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What a glorious, glorious, glorious thing to know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In chapter 1 of Ephesians,
na chapitre 1 Ephésiens,
Paul introduces us to a lavish God.
Zambe azali kolak, Paul azali kasebi som zambe oya bolingo.
A God who loves us so much and lavish His blessings upon us.
Zambe wazoli na biso bele e pia zo sopa li pamboli na ye liko na biso.
Paul tells us in chapter 1 that we have been blessed with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places.
Paul azo se biso ke to pambwa maki na bosu nyonso ya likolo e pa na zambe.
He tells us a lot of things that God and His Spirit has accomplished for us.
Azo se biso biloko mingi zambe asala pe molimo na ye sala ko na biso.
But when he gets into chapter 2,
tama komi na chapitre 2,
he says, hold on a minute. He says, wait a minute.
Alobi sala moke.
Let me tell you, before you understand what God has done for you, let me tell you who you were before God saved you.
Alobi tikale se bino boso sala oyo ozali.
He said, number one, you were dead in your sins and in your trespasses. You were a sinner out there in the world. You were under the control of a demon called the prince of the power of the air. It is the spirit that causes you to disobey God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, you are fulfilling the lusts of your flesh and the desires of your flesh. And by nature, children of wrath. But God, who is rich in mercy. God is rich in mercy. God is rich in mercy. And then he goes on to say, By grace you have been saved.
Et puis alobi na nzela na ngolu yo bikisamaki.
The grace of God.
Ngolu na zam
is what saved you.
Ezande ya mwe bikisiyo.
You are saved by grace.
Yo bikisama na ngolu
through faith.
Na nzela ya kondima.
You are saved by grace.
O bikisami na ngolu
through faith.
Na nzela ya kondima.
You are saved by the grace of God.
O bikisami na ngolu ya nzambe
through faith.
Na nzela ya kondima.
Therefore,
na yango,
you will be sustained in your walk with God. You will be sustained through your walk with God. By the grace of God. By the grace of God. This year,
2019.
The year of progress that is evident.
Année à progrès évident.
The year of progress that is evident.
Année à progrès évident.
What is going to make this progress evident in your life and in your ministry?
Oh, ya kosala ke progrès oh ezale évident na bomo na yo pe na lotomo na yo.
It's the grace of God.
Ezali ngolu ya nsambe.
And I pray for you today.
Ena sambele kuna yo lelo.
The grace of God will abound upon your life.
Ngolu na nsambe tonda na bomo na yo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, when the grace of God saved you, God didn't just leave you where you are.
Zambe azali kotiko disiko zali.
But Paul tells us in this chapter 2 of Ephesians,
Paul est ici dans chapitre 2 d'Éphésiens.
In verse 6 he says,
na verset 6 alobi,
and raised us up together and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Alobi asekusi biso elongo pe ayebi na kovansa biso elongo na bisika ya likolo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Think about it.
Kanisa na oyotali yango.
You are seated in this church right now, right here.
Ofandi na eglise oyo sikoyo pe na ngongo oyo.
And at the same time, you are seated with Christ in the heavenly
places.
Because you are a spirit being, you can live in two realms. That's why Paul said, we have been blessed with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. And he said that when you have been saved by the grace of God, that grace also lifts you up to be seated with Christ in the heavenly places. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we know, the power that controls everything is in heaven. And so what Paul is saying here is that we have been made to sit in power by the grace of God. What does this grace really mean? Grace simply means the favor of God that we are not qualified for, that we cannot work for, and that we cannot earn. It's a gift of God. There's nothing you can do in your life to be worthy of grace. There's nothing in my life that I can do to earn grace. Grace is what God gives us so that he can lift us up. Grace is what God gives us so that we can accomplish his purposes. This grace has lifted us up and caused us to sit with Christ in the heavenly places. Why? Paul says that in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness towards us in Christ.
Paul alobi poete na bikeko oyo koya e banakotalisa richesse na ye infini pe ngolu pe bolamu na ye kati na Yesu Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he says this grace is the gift of God.
Alobi ngolu ezali likabo ya Nzambe.
You didn't work for it, otherwise you will boast and say I work for it.
Osalele ngo musala te po tuta tolo kino na salagi musala po na zo yango.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But verse 10 says,
verset 10 le dit,
for we are his workmanship.
Pointe tozali ouvrage na ye.
Created in Christ Jesus for good works.
Tozali kati na Yesu pona misala malamu.
Which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them.
Onzambe abongisaki yango uta mela kala pointe tweba na kocha yango na misala.
This grace that saved you and I, that lifted us up into the heavenly place, that is the free gift of God,
it's
not for nothing.
It's
not for nothing.
God
has given us this grace so that we can do the work that he has prepared for us before time.
Work
that we have to do. God knows that we will need his grace to do his work. And so he lavished us with that grace. And so as you set about doing this work, I want to assure you by the authority of the word of God that the grace of God is available for you. That same grace that saved you,
parce que ngolu na ye bikisi yo,
is available for you.
Et puis ngolu wane sali capable pour na yo.
So do the work that God has sent you to do.
Pona kosala mosala nzamba sengi yo kosala.
Let me hear you say a big amen.
Nakoko kamena makasi.
Hallelujah. Now please go with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 3.
Tokene na mokanda na 1 Corinthians chapitre 3.
And please read verse 10.
1 Corinthiens chapitre 3, verset 10. Nous lisons au nom de Jésus. Selon la grâce de Dieu qui m'a été donnée, j'ai posé les fondements comme un sage architecte et un autre bâti dessus. Mais que chacun prenne garde à la manière dont il bâtit dessus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says here,
Paul a dit,
whatever work I have done in laying the foundation of salvation in your life, was talking to the Ephesians, to the Corinthians. Whatever God has accomplished through my life, in your midst,
oh, nyon son zambe akokisi kati na ngai na bomo na ngai na kati kati na bino.
And I know I have done a good work as a master builder.
Na evi ke na sali musala malam lokola motongi malam.
I want you to know it's only by the grace of God.
Na lingi boye ba kezali kaka na ngolu na zambe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 3 verse 8.
Ephesians chapitre 3 verset 8.
Ephesians chapter 3, verse
8. Ephesians chapitre 3, verset 8. Nous lisons au nom de Jésus. À moi, qui suis le moindre de tous les saints, cette grâce a été accordée d'annoncer aux païens les richesses incompréhensibles de Dieu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8,
Paul that, Alobi, na Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8,
that even though he was the least of all the apostles,
atoko atalaki moko ya muke ya ba Toma,
Paul did not see himself as qualified.
Paul ami moleki teke yene abongi na yango.
So he calls himself the least of the apostles.
Ami bengi le moindre.
But we know that he wrote 13 of the books in the New Testament.
Tu as dit que a commis 13 livres dans l'Ancien Testament.
Out of all the 27 books in the New Testament, he wrote 13 of them.
Et puis a commis ba livres ébélé.
And we know that some people believe that he wrote Hebrews also.
Ba tous ba kan sa rappelle qu'a commis hébreu.
So out of 27, He probably wrote 14 of the New Testament books.
Na 27 livres, a koma plus de 14.
But he said,
Alobi,
he said that it was by the grace of God that he was able to preach to the Gentiles.
Alobi, ezali na ngolu na nzambe ke na yebaki na koteya.
Hallelujah. Now let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 9 to 10.
1 Corinthians chapitre 15, verse.
Grace was given him to preach among the Gentiles.
Verse 9 à 10.
1 Corinthians 15, verse 9 and 10.
1 Corinthiens, chapitre 15, verset 9 à 10. Car je suis le moindre des apôtres. Je ne suis pas digne d'être appelé apôtre, parce que j'ai persécuté l'Église de Dieu. Par la grâce de Dieu, je suis ce que je suis. Et sa grâce envers moi n'a pas été vaine. Loin de là, j'ai travaillé plus que tous. Non pas moi toutefois, mais la grâce de Dieu qui est avec moi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Paul says,
Paul alobi,
I labor more abundantly.
Nasali mingi koleka.
That was a day Jesus was with his disciples.
Ezalaki na mokolo Yesu ayina baye kolina ye.
He looked at them and he said to them,
Atali bango atuni bango mutuna.
The harvest is plenty.
Alobi elanga eza monene.
But the laborers are few.
Kasi basali basali moke.
Pray that the God of the harvest will send laborers into his field.
Alobi mosambela ke nzambe mokolo elanga atinda basali kati na elanga na ye.
Pray that God will send laborers.
Sambela pote nzambe atinda basali.
The harvest is ripe.
Elanga eza monene.
But there are few laborers.
Me basali bazamuke.
So Jesus said to the disciples, pray that the God of the harvest will send laborers into the harvest.
Yesu ebisiba yekoli sambela ke nzambe atinda basali na elanga.
The harvest of the world is ripe.
Elanga oya mokilo ezali monene.
The harvest in Kinshasa is ripe.
Elanga kati na Kinshasa eza monene.
There are people who are confused who don't know what to do.
Bato bazali na ba confusion bazwe batelo koni bakoy kosala.
There are people who are around you who need Jesus that you have.
Ezale bele na bato o bazali zinga zinga na yo bazana posa ya Yesu.
All around you there are people who are seeking for the truth.
Zinga zinga na yo ezali na bato bazali koluka bilei ya molimo.
They are the harvest that this is right.
Yes, aline langwe za monene.
And you are the laborers that Jesus is looking for.
Yondo za mosali onzambe azali koluka.
And when you take on the job of a laborer for Jesus,
suki baliko sala mosala ya kolona hapo na Yesu,
to labor in his harvest for his kingdom.
Koyeba na kozua kugane bato pona bo konzi na ye.
Paul says,
Paul alobi,
you will labor abundantly,
okoyeba na kosala mingi,
than everybody else,
pe mutu mokote,
yet not you who is laboring,
oyo asali lokola yo,
but the grace of God that is going to be with you.
Memolu na nzambe ekozala likolo na yo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's review the encounter of Paul with Jesus Christ for a minute.
Total ananu musala pola sala ipo na Yesu mwamoke.
He was the one that was persecuting the Christians.
Ezalaki yende abana iko nyoko l'église.
Killing the Christians.
Kokoma ba Kristo.
Putting them in prison.
Kocha bango na boloko.
He was on a journey to Damascus one afternoon.
Azalaki iko sala voyage na Damascus moko msusu.
To persecute Christians.
Pona ko nyoko la ba Kristo.
Jesus Christ pulled him down from his horse.
Yesu ayebi na ko beta emo panzi.
Knocked him down in the dust.
Ayebi na ko bwake na poussière.
And said to him, Saul, Saul.
Ayebi siye Saul, Saul.
His name was Saul of Tarsus then.
Komo le zaleki Saul ya Tarsus.
Why are you persecuting me?
Pona nino zo nyoko langai.
And then he said to the voice that was speaking to him.
Ye ayanoli na mongongo zaleki kolo belaye.
Who are you, Lord?
Alobi kolo yonde nani.
Because Saul of Tarsus realized that the only power that could have knocked him down from his horse was a higher power from God.
Saul of Tarsus asosole ike nguya moko ko iko kwisi na mabele esaka ka nguya ya nzambe.
So when he heard the voice of the Lord Jesus Christ,
tamba yuki momo ya Yesu Kristo,
he called him Lord.
Abengiye Seigneur.
And Jesus said, I am Jesus whom you are persecuting.
Jesus a dit, ngai ne Jesus o nyokola.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is a dangerous thing to persecute a child of God.
It is a
dangerous thing for your enemy to try to persecute you.
Because when
you are working for Jesus,
when you are
laboring for
Jesus,
anyone that is persecuting
you is
persecuting your Lord and your
Master.
And very soon, they will fall down from their high place and hit the ground. Because the grace of God is upon your life. So Paul says, when I received this call, I was not disobedient. He said to Agrippa, this was what happened to me. I was knocked down from my horse. I had the voice of Jesus. I surrendered to him as my Lord. When you read that story in Acts of Apostles, the next thing Saul of Tarsus said to Jesus was, what will you have me do?
Eloko nini olinginga nasala.
Saul of Tarsus,
Saul ya Tarsus,
did not just hear the voice of Jesus.
Aluka kika mungu ya Yesu te.
I said, okay, so now I know you, Jesus.
Aluka ke wi na yo kina yebika yosa Yesu.
Bye bye, go your way, I go my way.
Ke aluka yo kene nzala na yo, ngapela ke nzala na ngai.
No, he knew that Jesus Christ is the Lord.
Aluka kike Yesu zala kinkolo.
And he said to him, what will you have me do? When you are a child of God, saved by grace, lifted up by grace, sitting in the heavenly realms by grace, prepare for the good work of God by grace, when the Lord Jesus calls you, your answer
is,
what will you have me do?
Oligina sala nini? Amen.
And that is the reason why grace was given to him more abundantly. It was the grace of God that made him to write a letter from prison. Writing to people who are not in prison and said to them, rejoice in the Lord. I say rejoice. The man in prison is encouraging the people outside of prison and telling them to have joy. When his own joy, the freedom that he has been taken away from him. Why? Because the grace of God was abundant in his life. That was why Paul never said in any of his epistles that he was imprisoned by Rome. It was not Rome. Rome. R-O-M-E. The Roman government.
Rome, yes.
Yeah. It was not Rome that put him in prison. He was always introducing himself as the slave and prisoner of Jesus. The grace upon him did not allow him to bow his knees to anybody else except the Lord Jesus Christ. So even the Roman government put him in prison, put his body in prison, they could not put his spirit and his soul in prison. And so they couldn't take his joy. When the grace of God is upon your life, when the grace of God abounds upon your life, no prison can hold you.
Please,
no prison can hold your spirit. No prison can hold your mind. Because the grace of God extends beyond the prison.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let
me round up my message this morning. By taking you to the book of Hebrews, chapter 4. And I want to read verse 16. Because you might be saying this morning, how do I obtain this grace? I want to share a few things with you. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16 says, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace. That we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. This is an epistle written to Hebrews. This is an epistle written to Jewish people. So they understand what Paul was saying here. In the old tabernacle of Moses, and in the old temples in the days of Jesus, the tabernacle or the tent of the temple was divided into three sections. You have the outer court. You have the inner court, and you have the holies of holies. And only the high priest can go into the holies of holies once every year to atone for the sins of Israel. And if there's any sin found in him, if he did not do the rituals that he was supposed to do very well, when he enters into the holies of holies, he will fall down and die. In fact, some people believe that there is a rope tied around the ankle of the high priest. When he's going into the holies of holies, and he has a bell in his hand, when he's doing his ministry, he's ringing the bell. If the bell stops ringing for a long time, they will pull him out by the rope around his ankles because they know that he's dead. So there's no high priest that goes into the holies of holies boldly.
Na courage.
No high priest can go into the holies of holies boldly. You start from the outer court. You kill an animal. You take the blood. He cleanses himself with the blood. He goes to the basin. The bronze basin. He washes himself.
Amisokoli.
And that's the only time he can step into the inner court. All the rituals must be performed. Then he takes incense from the inner court. He makes sure that everything in the inner court is working perfectly.
And then with fear and trembling, he
goes into the holiest of holies,
where
the ark of the covenant of the presence of God
is. And he walks
gently.
Filling
the whole place with
incense.
With the blood of the animal in his
hands. And
where he goes to is the ark of the
covenant. He
goes straight to the mercy
seat.
And he puts the blood on the mercy seat.
To
cover the sins of the children of Israel.
And
if he does that successfully,
then he
comes out,
and
the people know that their sins have been forgiven.
And they can continue
their life for one whole year.
But
when Jesus died on the cross,
the
Bible says
the
curtain separating the holiest of holies was
torn into two.
It was rent into two.
And
the Bible tells
us
that now
the
way into the holiest of
holies
has been opened for
us by
the blood of
Jesus.
The Bible says, the writer of Hebrews says,
Jesus
is now our high priest.
And
he has entered into the holiest of holies
once
and for
all.
And he has put his own blood on the mercy seat in
heaven. Which means
it is there permanently.
The way
to the throne room of God is now open for us.
And
we have access into that throne room by the blood of Jesus.
And with the
Spirit of God will go in there.
So here
Paul
says,
you can come boldly.
Come
boldly.
Come
boldly before the throne of grace.
Please,
can I have a chair? Thank you, Pastor. Can I have a chair? Thank you, Pastor. I want you to imagine in your heart
that
this is the throne of God. And let this brother represent God this morning. He's not God, but sit
down. Let's
say this is Jesus sitting at the right hand of God in heaven.
And here I am, Abraham,
a born-again Christian.
I have been
saved by the blood of Jesus.
I am a
born-again Christian. I have given my life to Jesus.
I have
said to him, what will you have me do?
The Bible says,
I can come boldly before the throne of grace. Because Jesus has made a way. I pass through the blood of Jesus.
In
my spirit,
I
don't have to crawl. I don't have to bow my head in shame.
The
word of God
says,
I can come boldly, respect.
I'm
coming boldly because I'm coming to my Father.
And the Bible says,
the moment I appear before the throne,
covers
me. The mercy of God covers
me.
It is the mercy that the blood of Jesus was shed for me.
It is
the mercy that brought grace into my life. And when that mercy covers It doesn't matter how I have come. It doesn't matter what I have done. The grace of God is present. Because of the mercy of God. Come boldly. Before the throne of grace. This is the throne of grace. It is not the throne of judgment. It is the throne of grace. A child of God that doesn't go every day before the throne of grace. You deny yourself mercy and grace. The songwriter says, you have to stop trying to analyze the message for yourself.
Okay.
Just preach with me.
Okay.
You get the message later. Okay. I know what he's doing. He's working it out in his own mind to get the benefit of it. Amen. So when you come before the throne of grace, it's not the throne of judgment. It's the throne of grace. You will expect mercy from God. Because the blood of Jesus has gone far, far ahead of you. He says, come before the throne of grace to receive mercy. And more grace to help you in your time of need. If you don't come, no mercy, no grace to help you. So what is this grace? It is an empowering grace. The grace of God empowers you to do the work that God has called you to do. Can I hear you say amen? Hallelujah. Let me finish with this story from the
Bible.
One day, Jesus was in a place.
Yes, was like in a sicker.
Please come, my dear sister.
Yaka, s'il vous plaît, ne commence.
Can I have you gentlemen in the front row? You, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes.
Cinq, cinq jeunes. Boya.
Yes, please. Come quickly.
Bande gumba. Boya, cinq.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus was in a place one day.
Yes, vous allez venir ici, Kamoko.
I want, please, sister, come and stand here.
Téléman.
Please come. Hold her hand here.
Simba loboko na ye.
No, hold her.
Simba loboko.
Yeah. Hold her with two hands.
Simba wambali.
Hold her with two hands.
Yope Simba loboko.
And the three of you come behind her.
Bino peboye na Simba.
Okay. Now come together. Come, drag her.
Boya na ye.
No. You are too gentle.
Go push her. Go push her.
And then they threw her on the floor. Before Jesus.
Before yes.
And then they said to Jesus.
Baby, see yes.
This woman. We caught her.
To kangi ye.
In the act of adultery.
To kangi ato sala kingumba.
And the law of Moses said.
Be kwa Moses elobi.
We must stone her to death.
Esengeni to bamba mabanga kufa.
Jesus.
Yes.
What do you say?
Olobini.
The Bible says.
Bibi olobi.
Jesus didn't answer them.
Yes, I know libangote.
He stooped down.
Afukami.
He was writing some things on the ground.
Epezai ko koma mama kabona amabele.
A crazy pastor I once met said.
Pastor Moko aza alobi boye.
He was writing the names of the men that brought him.
Alobi ke abane ko koma ba kombo ya bato ba mema yimwa sa ndumba wa.
See, they said we caught her in the very act of adultery.
Balobi to kangi azo sala adulteur.
The truth is,
bosole zali.
Where is the man?
Wapi mobadi na ye?
You brought her alone to Jesus.
Bo memeka ba mosi o sala adulteur.
Where is the man she was committing adultery with?
Bo wapi mobali o sala gina ye adulteur?
It takes two to commit adultery.
Ezo ba tumi ba le ko sala adulteur.
But you brought only the woman. woman to be killed. So Jesus stooped down, was righteous on the ground.
Yes,
he said, yes, Jeremiah. Yeah, you were with her last week. You were with her last week. You were with her the week before. And so after a while, Jesus said to them, any one of you that doesn't have a sin in your life, throw the first stone at her.
Bamba libanga liboso pana ye.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says, one by one, they let her go. They drop their stones on the ground. And in shame, they walk back to their house. So, gentlemen, please go back to your seat. Thank you.
No, wait.
This woman,
that
they said they caught in adultery, she was standing before Jesus with her head bowed. So when they were all gone, when all her accusers were gone, the Bible says that Jesus turned to her. As a woman, where are all the people that accuse you
now?
So she lifted up her head. Jesus will lift up your head. In front of your accusers. In front of your accusers. Jesus will lift up your head. Grace lifts up your head. Grace will lift up your head. The grace of God will lift up your head. She lifted up her head. She looked around. She looked around. She talks to Jesus. She said to
Jesus,
no one, Lord.
Mokote kolo.
Where are your accusers now?
Wapi bafundi na yo?
No one, Lord.
Ata mokote azali.
You will lift up your head.
Okotoma la mutu na yo.
You will look around.
Okotoma la mutu.
All your accusers will disappear.
Bafundi na yo bakobunga.
Because of the grace of God.
Bona mbolu na zambe.
So Jesus turns to her.
Yesu abaluge pai na ye.
Woman. Since you said there are no accusers, I am grace. I am grace. The sin you have committed, I take it upon myself. I'm taking it to the cross. Therefore, you are set free. Go and sin no more. When they brought her to Jesus, they thought they were bringing her to the high priest. No, they brought her before the grace of God. And grace sets you free. Grace sets you free.
Please.
Grace sets you free. They brought her before the throne of grace. Mercy covered her. And grace was given her to go and sin no more. Whatever you are struggling with in your life, challenges in your life, difficulties in your life, come before the throne of grace. Receive mercy. And grace for help. Because you are in need. God bless you, my sister. And so that woman went home. With mercy.
And
the empowerment of grace.
Et puis na nguya ya ngolu.
To live above her circumstances.
Koyeba na kovivwa likolo na circumstances.
Maybe you are here today.
Tamso zali awalelo.
You haven't really given your life to Christ.
Nano pesipo mone pa Yesu te.
I'm sure pastor is going to call you.
Na zasu ke pasa ko benga yo.
To come to grace.
Pona uya liboso na ngolu.
So that you can receive mercy.
Pona ozo apema wananzam.
Let me assure you.
Sikana sireyo.
Progress that has evidence.
Progrès évident.
Progress that has evidence.
Progrès évident.
Multitudes.
Multitudes.
Building a nation and a kingdom for Jesus in Congo.
Kotonga nation pe bokonzi na nzambe na Congo.
It will be challenging. But the grace of God is
there.
The grace of God is upon you. The grace of God is upon
you.
And so Paul,
Paulo,
whenever he's writing to the churches, when you read all of his letters, he will say, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. That's what he's saying. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ that was brought into our lives by the love of God and the Holy Spirit that causes us to have fellowship with him will remain with us. What does that mean? It means every day. Grace is available. Love of God is available. And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit is available. I pray for you today. Grace will lift you up. As you stand before God, as you serve God, in this vision of self, grace will set you free. Mercy will cover you. And Christ will lift you up. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you.